Just wanted to start this vlog saying I'm up. It is 9:27 and I'm already about to roll and go work on the basement.
100,000 for the cheapest ring on the nigga finger, little bitch. Ooh, I done flew one out to Spain to be in my domain, automata, bitch. Ooh, dropped $3 on the rain, called it Bentley truck, little bitch. Ooh, I was in the trap serving cocaine, they ain't been the same since. Ooh, granted, she was standing right there while I catch play on the brick. Ooh.
All right, my family, quick visual update. I got the first coat on over here, y'all. This should be dry by tomorrow. Tomorrow, I'll do a thick second coat and a third coat. Then I'm all done with this wall. And this turned out pretty good, y'all. Y'all remember at first I was putting these pieces up for this. It's actually turned out real good. As you can see, a little rivet in there, but that's cool. That's only a second coat. So another coat gonna make that look nice and smooth. And I got this part down. I know I barely show y'all this part, but it was like some wood paneling right here. Got this down. Of course, we're gonna throw this out, get some new shit over here. Got this little piece of wood. Sorry, not piece of wood, piece of drywall right here. Yeah, we coming along though, fam. We coming along. Painting is, you know, coming up next. Well, after I sand this all down, I then gotta put some primer up. We get the paint up, then we get started on the roof or the ceiling, and then we get in the carpet, then we ready to rock and roll, fam. Boom! Quick food update. We got the homemade fries over here. And when I say they're homemade, they are homemade. This is from a potato. Cut from a potato. That's a potato, potato. And then we got the cheeseburger over here. Let's show y'all this real quick. Voila, homemade as well, of course. And then we're about to edit this vlog over here. It's now 7:07 p.m. Took like a 2-hour nap after I got done working on the basement. And yeah, let's roll. Listen, when your brother got the do-rag on, you know I'm about to go to bed. It's like how the ladies wear their bonnets, and you know when she got her bonnet on, she ain't leaving the house. When my do-rag is on, that is it. But what's good, my family? Just got home. It is currently, let's see what time it is today, y'all. 3:36 a.m. I got in 1.5 hours earlier than yesterday, y'all, because Uber was going. You know what I mean? A lot of people always ask me, how are you getting money from Uber and you do Uber at night? That's the best time to do it, because when you do it during the day, right? Listen, I'm going to break down some free game for y'all. Doing Uber during the day is dope, you know what I mean? Definitely for ladies that don't like driving at night and stuff. That's cool. But for me personally, Uber during the day is slow because it's a lot of people out there doing Uber, a lot of Uber drivers, and a lot of older people do Uber. And you know, they ain't about to go out at night, so they drive around all day. And therefore, it's more drivers than more people that need Uber. So therefore, you don't make as enough money. But at night, there's not a lot of Uber drivers out there. And guess what? I'm out there getting that money while everybody's asleep. You dig? Prime example of being a hustler, man. I tell y'all, you gotta hustle for what you want in your own way. You know what I mean? My hustle right now is getting Uber money to invest in myself, to travel and do everything I want to do. But Uber is dope, y'all. No interesting stories today, for real. Just had a lot of conversations. You know what, y'all? That's one thing I do like about Uber. I have a ton of conversations about a whole bunch of random shit. And I feel like the people come in the car to vent to me because, number one, they don't know me. And number two, I always bring out those good vibes. I'm always, hello there, you know what I mean? And as soon as they sit down, we have the greatest conversation ever. And I take what I can from that conversation and I go on to the next person. So yeah, overall, I enjoy doing Uber. I love this shit, actually, you know what I mean? It's gonna be a sad day when I have to stop doing it, but I'm enjoying it for now, you dig? But let's see what I gotta tell y'all. Actually, I gotta wake up in the next 3 to 4 hours. I'm about to do another video shoot. This is like a behind the scenes video shoot for something else. It's with Donna again. I don't know if I can tell y'all what's about to happen, but long story short, she got some business moves she about to do. So we about to do that, I think, at 8 a.m. It's 3 a.m. right now, so gotta wake up in 3 hours once again, like I did today. And by the way, y'all, waking up earlier today wasn't that bad as I thought it was gonna be. You know what I mean? I woke up, had my coffee, and I was just nonstop. Took a 2-hour nap after I got done working in the basement. And damn, I'm over here hitting shit. I'm fucking up today. But yeah, let's get straight to the fun facts of the day, y'all. Let's get straight to it. Hold on. I didn't pull up today. Oh my gosh. Hold on. Hold on 1 second. All right. What's today's date? Just make sure it's the right day. February 4th, 2020. Damn. 2020. That's crazy. Thought of the day. There is very little difference in people, but that little difference makes a big difference. The little difference is attitude. The big difference is whether it is positive or negative. Why you had to confuse me like that, W. Clement Stone? You could just make this a lot more simpler, and I gotta reread it to myself. There's very little difference in people, but that little difference makes a big difference. The little difference is attitude. The big difference is whether it is positive or negative. Yeah, your attitude is everything. Like I told you a minute ago, people come in my car, I'm always, hello there. I'm not like, hey, what's up? Like, no, man. I really believe in having a positive attitude, you know what I mean? Although, at times, we do have fucked up days, fucked up shit happens, but at the end of the day, you gotta spread that good energy, man, because it comes back to you, you know what I mean? Whatever you put out to the universe, it comes back to you times 10. I learned that throughout my whole life, you know what I mean? Of course, I'm still young, I'm still learning, but one thing I do know is the energy you put out into the world, it comes right back to you all the fucking time. It comes back into you in different ways, though. You may think it may be a boom, but no, it comes back in small increments. I noticed that. So that's why it's all about having a good attitude, you know what I mean, having a good personality. It don't take out your anger at other people. Let's say if you're angry over a situation, it's not fair to take it out on this next person. This person did nothing to you, you know what I mean? That's why I really believe in just having a good attitude, you know. Simple as that. Joke of the day. How do rubber bands warm up? How? They stretch. Random fact of the day. When you are driving on the highway, the car engine is hot enough to cook a piece of chicken. By the way, Neek and Tony, yes, that chicken was straight from the back. I just playing. But yeah, I mean, I guess your car is kind of hot. I haven't touched a super hot engine before, and I don't plan on doing that. But I did actually burn my hand. I wonder if the mark's still here. Well, I used to work on cars a lot, and we took out the engine of my Camaro, right? And I don't know why the oil was hot, but the oil was super hot, and I actually was trying to change the oil and everything, and it burned my arm. Luckily, the burn, you can see it a little bit. I don't know if y'all can see it. Luckily, the burn don't show. But yeah, don't touch a car engine while it's hot. Don't try it. Please don't do that. No, just don't. Journal entry idea. What is your favorite thing about the month of February? Ooh, Valentine's Day. No, honestly, the favorite thing about February, I can't even give y'all anything, but I'm about to just think of some bullshit to say. The best thing about February to me, honestly, is that, hey, we're a step closer to the summer. You know what I mean? It feels like when we get over November, December, January, it's like, all right, although we're still in wintertime, we're like focused on spring. You know what I mean? We're focused on the next season. February is usually when Cleveland and, you know, Ohio, wherever, gets this big snowstorm and all. But after this, y'all, we're just looking forward to spring. You know what I mean? Next, like in March, for instance, spring break happens for the college kids and all the clothing stores start selling spring clothes. So it gets us in that mindset like, oh, my God, warm days are coming. Sunny days are coming. And me personally, I'm excited because knowing it's February, I'm getting closer and closer to, you know, when I'm going out the country for a month, you dig? I still have yet to tell the date because one day y'all just gonna come on my channel and y'all gonna see a vlog of me out the country. But while this being said, my family, I gotta wake up in the next few hours, 3.5 hours. While that being said, I'm gonna talk to y'all tomorrow. Peace and love.